on this piece of paper, the innocent phone conversation may never reach an enemy agent. And perhaps most of the time he's not actually around. But considering the risks, is it worth taking a chance? We'd like you to consider that question for the next few moments. Most of us know what classified material is and how to handle it. We know that all classified information and material must be protected and safeguarded. And we know that we aren't supposed to talk about classified information in areas that are not secure. But do you know that by careful gathering of information and observation of activities that are only related to classified operations, that practically anyone can reconstruct certain aspects of that operation? It has been done. The way to protect that information is by proper application of operation securities, OPSEC. The overall purpose of OPSEC is to keep the enemy from gaining information that could be used against us. The proper protection of classified material is a part of OPSEC, but so is the protection of seemingly trivial, unclassified information or actions which are related to classified projects. In other words, OPSEC is overall security, keeping the advantage on our side. OPSEC is doing your part on your job to keep the information from falling into enemy hands. Though the official OPSEC program is relatively new, it actually began in 1966. When a rapid increase in mission failures began occurring in Southeast Asia. All too often, our fighter aircraft were attacking target areas where no targets existed. And our photo reconnaissance aircraft were ambushed by enemy ground fire that was not supposed to be on hand. Obviously, the enemy was gaining information about our strike plans in time to take countermeasures, robbing us of our most vital strike asset, the element of surprise. Concern over these losses led to a full-scale survey of our combat operations in Southeast Asia. The study revealed that without violating any security rules, we were telegraphing our punches by establishing standard flight patterns, which enabled the enemy to predict important aspects of an operation. By posting flight schedules in areas where local nationals could read them, and by sending unclassified messages which revealed facts about specific activities, and by generally ignoring the fact that the enemy had a highly sophisticated network of English-speaking radio intercept operators who could notify their commands immediately when they learned that a strike was imminent. Through this field study of combat security conditions, we were able to eliminate many information leaks, and combat effectiveness improved. The present OPSEC program, established under AFR 5530, was developed during these years of application in the field. So it's pretty easy to see how OPSEC can apply during combat conditions. But how does it apply during peacetime, and what can you do about it right now? Let's have a look at some Air Force people. People much like ourselves, going about their daily Air Force and private affairs, and getting into the type of situations which can compromise the security of Air Force operations.
Does this look okay to you?
Yeah, fine.
Are you about ready?
In a minute. And don't forget, you promised to be nice to George tonight.
Okay. But he is such a jerk. Turner residence. Hi, Sarge. Hey, wait a minute. Right now? Well, I wasn't scheduled for that until tomorrow night. All right. Okay. Fine. Bye.
Don't tell me. Work. Damn it, Jim. What am I going to tell George and Helen?
Now, wait a minute. This wasn't my idea. This is part of that top secret project that I told you about last week. You can tell Helen and what's-his-face whatever you want. I won't be long.
Hello, Helen? Hi, this is Betty Turner. Fine, but I'm afraid we won't be able to make it tonight. No, Jim has to go on some classified project tomorrow and he has to make some last-minute checks or something. Yes, well, I was counting on it too. Okay, I'll call you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
What do you tell an angry wife? Jim took the easy way out. He told her the truth. Just a minor incident. No security violation. But Jim's OPSEC was poor. Unimportant? Perhaps. But Jim didn't have to tell his wife he was going on a classified mission. And their friends didn't have to know either.
Oh, could you wait just a moment, please?
Sure. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. A sheet of carbon paper. A notice posted on the bulletin board. Unclassified material, unclassified actions. But in the wrong hands, potential trouble. Such special alerts or notices would better be passed verbally. And if they have to be posted, use a bulletin board where not just anyone has access. And of course, all efforts to protect the information will be useless if the carbon is readily available. Unimportant? Maybe so. But why make the opportunity available?
That's 15 spaces on the fourth. Thank you, sir. Yes?
I'm Major Adams. We had reservations for 11 crew members.
Major Adams, just a moment, please. Sorry, sir, we just don't have anything for you.
Well, we were notified that all arrangements were made. Someone must have contacted you about holding these rooms.
I'm sorry, sir. Just one moment.
Listen, I have 10 guys outside. We're here on a classified project. We're leaving in the morning. You must have something for just tonight.
Oh, here it is, sir. I'm sorry. The night clerk must have gotten a message. Would you please sign this? Fill it out.
Okay. No harm done.
No problem. The clerk found the reservations. The rooms were ready. But, no harm done? Well, this man is feeling real sorry for himself.
I can't come home tonight.
He has to work all night. Overtime.
About special meals.
Like a good husband, he's calling his wife to let her know that he'll be late because he has to prepare specially packaged meals by morning. Something about a special project. There's nothing wrong with calling his wife, but is he telling her too much? Maybe. Anyway, she doesn't need to know about the special project.
Hi, can I help you?
I hope so. I need this flight suit cleaned as soon as possible. Can I have it in an hour?
You sure can.
Oh, good.
And your name?
Turner. Betty Turner.
There you are.
Thank you very much.
Evidently, Jim read the special notice and added a little reminder of his own. No security violation. Just a note that by itself is unclassified and harmless, but it should have been destroyed. Of course, the cleaning girl is okay. Point is, she doesn't need to know.
Motor pool dispatcher.
Just some routine business here.
Okay, can I please...
Motor pool dispatcher gets a call to have a bus at the VOQ at 0700 the next morning. They're to transport a group of men to base operations. And supply gets an order for additional desert gear. A rush order. The sergeant puts it through immediately. Just routine. No problem here. As a matter of fact, good OPSEC. A motor pool dispatcher and a supply sergeant getting their jobs done. Later, though.
So as she was...
After work.
She stuck her head back in the door, and she says, anything you want, baby, I get paid by the year.
Eric, what's happening? Hey, have a beer, huh?
Hi, Bill. Beer's fine. Mick, please.
Okay. Hey, how's work? Have they been hassling you over some extra buses? I think it's some special project or something. What is new?
Yeah, you two, they got to me today with some rush special handling on desert gear.
Must be gonna play in the sand. And in this heat, too, I'm glad it's not me.
OPSEC doesn't end at the office. The bartender? Oh, he's 100% okay. He's just a bit curious, that's all. And always, 24 hours a day, there are people making long-distance calls via Autobahn. A large number of these calls are relayed by microwave radio, making them extremely vulnerable to enemy interception. So state your business and let it go at that. Don't tell too much. OPSEC is concerned not only with the present and future, but also with the past. In this case, an information officer is preparing a story for publication. It describes a recently completed exercise which was held in the desert. Maybe this story is okay. But does it tell about our procedures and tactics? Does it list units or individuals involved? What about special operations or problems? Are they mentioned? If this was simply a training exercise, perhaps it doesn't matter. But if this was a dry run of the real thing, what have we revealed? From all the bits and pieces involved, each one harmless by itself, we learned of a top secret project. We know there was going to be a special briefing. We discovered the number of men involved in a classified project and when it begins. We know the operation was urgent. We learned the takeoff time. We learned the general area of the exercise, and we discovered the purpose of the exercise itself. What else is needed to compromise the operation? If anything is required, the enemy will probably have it. That's their job. And it's part of your job to keep them from getting it. We can protect our classified material perfectly. We can change our operational procedures to disguise them or confuse the enemy. We can guard our bases and our equipment. But if we blow it all before we start, what's the use? In the final analysis, OPSEC is everyone's responsibility. That's where the whole problem of security rests, on the individual and his attitude towards it. So, what's your attitude? Too many of us rate security pretty low on our list of priorities. We tend to feel that it interferes with our work. prevents us from getting our job done. If that's your attitude, think why you're doing your job. Isn't it a part of the whole Air Force mission? And isn't that mission aimed at defeating our enemies, whomever they may be and wherever it may be required? There's no purpose at all in conducting an operation that's destined to fail. And fail it surely will. The enemy knows in advance what our operations are all about. A working OPSEC program can prevent that. But only you can make OPSEC work.